Hi, my name is Jeff Lambright, and I'm going to walk you through the steps to align a Sutter two-photon imaging system, particularly a Sutter Movable Objective Microscope. For our Sutter Movable Objective Microscope, we sell an alignment kit to assist you in aligning your microscope. This kit consists of an alignment laser that fits into the objective holder of the MOM, as well as a pinhole for the tube lens and a pinhole for the scan lens that will enable us to center the alignment beam through the microscope. We can then set up pinholes on the table using the centered alignment beam. Then, as a final step, we will run the imaging laser through the table pinholes and into the system. With a final tweak for centering the beam, the system will be ready and optimized for imaging. Step 1. Assemble the alignment tool with the objective holder so it can replace the objective in your system. Step 2. Remove the front cover of the MOM. And very carefully thread on the pinhole for the tube lens. You'll notice the mirrors on the head of the microscope are very close to where you are working. Please be extremely careful not to touch, bump, scratch, or even look at them too closely. They are very delicately mounted on their brackets in order to reduce stress on the optical elements, so they are quite easy to break off. Step 3. Very carefully remove the scan lens cover. And slide the unthreaded scan lens pinhole over the front of the scan lens. Now both pinholes are in place, which will be used to align the alignment beam through the center of the optical path. If your CCD mirror is in the way, loosen the scan lens set screw and slide the scan lens back just enough to insert the pinhole. Remember to be careful to return the scan lens back to its exact position after removing the pinhole later. Step 4. Use both the translational adjustment, the top thumb screws, as well as the angular adjustment, the bottom thumb screws, to guide the laser beam through the pinholes. At this point, the alignment beam should be going through both pinholes and onto the scanning mirrors. On the Galvo scanner mirrors, you can see the beam positioned on the mirrors. On Sutter's enclosed resonant scanner, or on Vidrio's rapid multi-region scanner, these will be inside the enclosed box, but you will still be able to see the beam exiting the periscope once the scanners are centered. It's important to note at this point that the scanning mirrors must be centered for this to work. If the scanning mirrors are not centered, we will not have anything close to a good beam alignment when we finish. So, step 5 is to center the scanning mirrors. For centering Galvo-Galvo mirrors, start with the controller powered off. On the back of the controller, unplug the BNC cables for the X and Y control, but make sure the gray scanner cables that goes from the controller to the scanner stay connected. Now, power the controller back up, and the mirrors should make a little jump to their centered position, about a second or so after flipping the controller on. For resonant scanners, also start with the controller powered off. On the back of the MDRR controller, unplug the Y BNC cable. Then additionally, unplug the resonant scanner cable from the back of the controller. Then power it up, and the scanners should jump to their centered position about 1 second after flipping the switch back on. At this point, with the scan mirrors sitting in their centered position, the beam should be pointing straight down the periscope tube, coming out of the center of the periscope tube and reflecting off the mirror at the bottom of the tube across the table toward a mirror that would direct it then towards the imaging laser. It may be interesting to note that if this was a new install, this is when the MOM main rail height would be adjusted so that the beam coming out of the back of the periscope was exactly the same height as the beam coming out of the imaging laser. Step 7. Now we can put the pinholes on the table, marking our alignment beam coming out of the periscope. Generally, the 45-degree mirror on the bottom of the periscope is not adjusted, unless the beam is not coming straight out of the back and horizontal. Tighten the pinholes precisely around the center of the beam. At this point, it is likely that the alignment beam is reflecting off of the first mirror behind the scope, potentially even off the second mirror, and then making its way back towards the laser. I like to use this as my opportunity to reposition any mirrors necessary by aligning the beam backwards towards the imaging laser. This will get my imaging beam closer to the target when we switch over to the imaging laser and work it back through the microscope. Step 8. Remove the alignment laser. Once your imaging laser is on and warmed up, open the shutter to begin using the imaging beam. Always wear safety glasses when working with the powerful IR imaging beam. An IR viewing card will assist in safely viewing the beam. If your laser has an alignment mode, use it. An alignment beam is generally a much lower power beam that is safer to work with, and it's also visible red, so it's easier to see than the IR beam. If your laser does not have an alignment beam, tune it to its shortest possible wavelength at which it will stably operate. Use your Pockel cell or half-wave plate and polarizer combination to reduce the output power of the beam to a very safe level. Step 9. Use the last two mirrors before the periscope of the microscope to adjust the beam into and through the two table pinholes you just fixed to the table. Once the imaging laser is through the center of those two pinholes, you are very close to a perfectly aligned system. Go ahead and open your pinholes once the beam is centered. The final step is to remove the alignment pinholes over the tube lens and scan lens on the back of the microscope and view the imaging beam on the back aperture of the objective. This is easily done by sliding a piece of business card or paper in the narrow space directly over the objective. This will allow you to view the shape and position of the beam. It should either be round, or you will perhaps see some of the edges of your scanning mirrors if the beam is expanded to fully fill them. The last adjustment you need to make is to tweak the last mirror before the periscope tube to center the beam through the objective. I generally do this by looking both at a piece of paper above the objective, as well as putting a piece of paper underneath the objective to make sure that the light throughput of the objective is round and even. Now your Sutter 2-photon microscope should be optimized for imaging. This completes beam alignment of your 2-photon laser scanning system, the Sutter Movable Objective Microscope. Leaving the two pinholes on the table will allow for quick checks and potentially easy corrections of the beam alignment of your system. However, if there are any unexpected variations, it's recommended to start the alignment procedure from the beginning as we have shown here. Happy imaging!
Please call us or email info@sutter.com for a quote. Additional product information is also available on our website. Explore our YouTube channel to find the latest support videos and product announcements. Subscribe now.